everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Omolola, and in this vlog, I am in the beautiful country of Peru. I had 4 days to explore Cusco, and I was amazed by just how beautiful this city was. Stay tuned to see what I did, where I stayed, what I ate, and much, much more. Like and subscribe for more travel vlogs. We actually flew into Cusco from Trujillo, Peru. We had spent a few days there just to recharge before continuing our adventure through South America. We visited 3 cities in Colombia first, so definitely check those vlogs out as well.
It's not here, is it?
The first full day in Cusco began with a walking tour of the city hosted by a local. If you've been here for a minute, you know I always like to start a new city with a tour. We got to learn so much about the history of Cusco and the whole region of South America. During our walking tour, we were told that guinea pig is a local delicacy, so we found a restaurant to try some. I'd had it a few times before I moved to the US, so I was excited to try it again. We walked to a restaurant called Yaku, and they serve traditional Peruvian dishes.
Hasta abajo.
For our second day, we chose to do a day trip to Machu Picchu, which is one of the seven wonders of the world. The bus set out at 4 a.m. to the train station. The train took us to the town of Aguas Calientes. This town is a short bus ride to Machu Picchu. Some people opt to stay the night in Aguas Calientes, but we plan to only spend one day. After getting to Aguas Calientes, we ended up spending about 5 hours there. It's a beautiful town and there were the most majestic, mist-covered mountains everywhere you looked. We just kept ourselves busy by walking around and eating while we waited for our time slot for the guided tour of Machu Picchu.
Machu Picchu.
Tupa Manchis Gama.
Tupa Manchis Gama.
Perfect. That was just a warm up. Please do it properly. You can open your hands, project them to the mountain. If not, it's fine. No problem. But please close your eyes. Close your eyes. Please, we're going to share a special moment now. We are going to take a deep breath. Hold it. And exhale softly. Visualize Machu Picchu in your minds and repeat after me, please. Añay.
Añay.
Machu Picchu.
Machu Picchu.
Tupa Manchis Gama.
Tupa Manchis Gama.
Perfect.
We headed back to the middle of Aguas Calientes for the last hour and a half, and our train was for 8 p.m. We had pollo a la brasa, which is a Peruvian-style rotisserie chicken. We had heard so much about it. This situation started out innocently enough, and most of us could understand a delay of even an hour or two, but it got much worse. We were meant to get to our Airbnb at 11 a.m. that day, but we ended up not getting back until 7 a.m. the next day. By then, couples were fighting on the train, women were crying. At some point, we had to climb out of the train and into another train in the middle of the dark jungle. But you know, things like this happen sometimes. We just tried to stay positive, even though it was absolutely chaotic and no one really told us what was going on. We were glad to have made it home safely and grateful we didn't have a flight or something the next day. So when we were back, I ate the rest of my guinea pig and went right to sleep. I finally woke up close to dinner time and gave my sister a phone call to laugh about the craziness of the night before. Then we headed over to the Museum of Pre-Columbian Arts just to get a sense of how people lived during Incan times. Our curiosity about the era was definitely piqued after visiting Machu Picchu. On our final morning, we walked over to St. Peter's Church to get some drone shots of Cusco before we left for the airport. Thank you so much for watching my longest vlog yet. Our next stop in Peru is the city of Lima. Like and subscribe to see more travel vlogs. Bye!